So the burden for kids came during my tenure at the department, because what would happen was when we would have to go into the jail, the county jail, to take somebody that, you know, we've arrested or go interview somebody, and I'd see these kids in the holding tanks. And disproportionately, black kids, brown kids. And after seeing that, you know, so much, it really started to weigh on me. And so I started having a conversation with God, you know, God, what are we gonna do about this, you know?
I just want to say thank you for being a role model in my life and giving me many words of wisdom and sage advice. I want to wish you well on the next phase of your life as well. Stay blessed.
Congratulate you on that. You've been changing lives, young men's lives, for 30 years. You've touched me in some way, changed my life in some way. And now, you know, you're off on another path, and whatever God has in store for you, I'm pretty sure it'll be something that you'll excel in.
Thank you for being there for all the kids at a certain time. Some people might be in a different, you know, different setting, but you love each and one of us as your own son. So thank you.
You're retiring because, I don't know, I was just thinking about the other day, you know, some of the things I did with you and Mr. Willis, and some of the other people that went to Clips with me. Like how we rode in the minivans together and went on the golfing trips. What else? I remember those times where I would get in trouble and you would make me write a full page paper on why I shouldn't do what I did. And most of the times I wouldn't do it again, but I know sometimes I would. But thank you, Mr. Crawford, for being a great mentor slash father figure slash role model in my life. And happy retirement. I hope all goes well with you. And I do hope I get to see you soon.
Thank you. Thank you for the 30 years you have sacrificed your life to hope for. Thank you for giving me the opportunity some boys wasn't able to get. And thank you for being such a great role model to me and to some of the other boys.
You're strong, yeah. We need a
real God.
Yeah, yeah. The God with the
resurrection power from the grave
to take away the hate, to heal the human race. See, we need a, we need a,
we need a,
we need a strong God. See, we need a,
we need a,
we need a.
As I like to describe Mr. Crawford to people that I introduced to him, is Mr. Crawford, you are definitely the wisest person that I know.
I just wanted to thank you for your many long years of service to the Hope Farm boys and their moms, and especially for your relentless commitment to God's word and not wavering on that, especially when our culture is really, really moving away from it.
Just don't preach the gospel. Be the gospel.
My country, tears of thee, sweet land of liberty. When will we finally see? We need a strong God. Yeah.
Thank you so much for all that you've invested, not just in Hope Farm, but into me personally. I'm going to miss you and I hate to see you go, but I know that this is not the end, but it's just the beginning. God is still writing out your story and he's still writing out Hope Farms. So keep the faith because he has a plan. Love you.
And I can't thank you enough for how much you've allowed God to use you to impact my life. And so I thank you. I appreciate you.
Listen, Mr. Crawford, a person who is admired or idealized for courage, outstanding achievements, and of noble qualities, is what a hero is. And if anybody deserves the hero title, it is you. I want to say
your strive after God, and you really desire to want to please him. And you've been a great role model to me, and I'm trying to get in your Bible study because I still want to just stay connected. But there's not too many men I could say I really look up to, and I really look up to you a lot, man, and who you are.
great unknown where feet may fail, and there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith.
Your love for the Lord and the Lord's love for you is so evident in how you love others and how you treat us.
And keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am
such a great example of Christ to us, and encouragement to us in marriage and in parenting. And we just love you and pray that this is one of the greatest seasons of your life.
Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. My feet may fail.
Hey, Mr. Crawford, wow, I am so excited for you. I heard a rumor that you're gonna be retiring after 100 years of ministry. Oh my God. No, I'm joking. I don't think you've been doing ministry for 100 years, but I know the impact that you've had has been as if you've done ministry for 100 years, especially in my life. You've showed up time and time again, whether it was teaching me how to garden, teaching me work ethic as a young man, growing up around Hope Farm. You ministered to me and my mother and my family in so many different ways. You showed up to high school musicals and plays down at the Jubilee, to showing up at my high school graduation and my college graduation, and just a lot of different times in my life. You've been there for me and prayed for me and interceded for me and been such a tremendous mentor, you as well as Mr. Randall. And I can't say a million times how thankful and grateful I am for your ministry. So I pray that you enjoy this new season that God is about to transition you into. I believe that you're not gonna necessarily slow down in terms of the effectiveness that you're gonna have for the kingdom of God, but these are gonna be tender years that God is gonna do something even greater through you, and through your ministry is just gonna look different. So I love you from Atlanta, Georgia, from the ATL. Please hear me say I love you, and congratulations on all that you've done in this format of ministry, and I'm looking forward to what God is going to do with you next. I love my Hope Farm family. Hope to see y'all soon one day. Peace out.
Gary, wow, on this bright sunshining morning, what an amazing opportunity to send kind words to someone that we know and love dearly. Who can we think of that we admire more than this man, Noble Crawford? It's amazing. When you think of Noble, what would you say, Gary?
I would say,
as he's leaving,
I would say it's good to give a good word and a timely word. And so, Noble, I just wanted to just thank you and praise you. Praise God for you. and thank you for being my friend.
Noble, we know that what is to come is not the end, it's the beginning, because even though you're retiring and you're leaving, you're only just beginning. And also, it doesn't stop here. What you have to offer the world and what you've offered in your 30 years at Hope Farm has been amazing, and you will only continue to do that.
Here's to you.
Coffee. How many mornings did you guys have coffee together? So a toast to Noble with coffee. I don't drink coffee, but I toast you as well. Love you.
Love you, bro.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Take me